Greetings from Zagreb Airport. Today we are flying to Lisbon with TAP Air Portugal in business class. The airline has been in existence for 17 years longer than Zagreb Airport. This is the new terminal, which is very modern. Let's get into the check-in area. This departure board is unfortunately placed as it reflects the sun very strongly, making it very hard to read. The check-in area is spacious and very bright. It looks like that check-in for our TAP flight has not been open yet. We will just skip the check-in desks as I have already checked in online, which I suggest to everyone who travel just with carry-ons. The security check area is one floor up from the check-in hall. When I was there on a Thursday morning, it was very empty and it didn't take much time to pass it. With your TAP business class ticket, you are entitled to enter the prime class lounge, which is the only business lounge in Zagreb Airport. Therefore, it serves a number of airlines and loyalty programs, as you can see on this board. To the left from the entrance are the workstations and two massage chairs. Further in is the quiet section of the lounge with a coffee station and some small snacks and fruits. The dining area offers a lot of dining tables, but mostly it offers a pleasant variety of food and drink options. Besides sandwiches, salads, fruits and a variety of pastries which are offered throughout the day, they offer also one hot option. As I was there during lunchtime, the hot option was a soup. In the morning, I already had cheese omelets on my previous visits. While sandwiches are wrapped in plastic, which makes it possible to take them on board, the drinks, besides water and yogurt, are served in glass bottles, which are really unpractical for taking on board. If something, then this lounge would need to replace the coffee machine, as the present makes really poor coffee. The selection of spirits and Croatian wines is good, and you can make your own pancakes too. As it is 45 minutes to departure time, I make myself on the way to the gate, which is the last one on this terminal, making it the furthest away from the lounge. However, walking to the gate takes maximum 5 minutes. The terminal offers decent number of seats. The benches do not have the armrest and could be used for sleeping too, but that rarely comes handy, as there are not many passengers that would have a connection overnight time in Zagreb. Smokers can use smoking lounges, which can be found in the terminal. That also means that there is no outside viewing platform, which is a downside. Actually, I didn't see any viewing platform here at all. I cannot show you the plane that will take me to Lisbon, because there is no view of it from the terminal. This is a Lauda airplane that is being pushed onto the taxiway. So, boarding begins.
Business class passengers to approach the gate. Thank you.
Hold on.
Hello, mama.
This is my seat, 2F. While row 1 will give you just one window, the bulkhead and smaller tray tables in the armrests, row 2 gives you two windows and a standard tray table. Cabin is in 3-3 configuration in all classes. In business class, there is more leg room. There's also a USB and international power plug under the seat in front of you. The seats don't have screens, but they do have a tablet holder, and they recline. The economy seats in TAP planes don't recline. It is time to leave the gate. It is time for a pushback. While the plane taxis to the runway, let me ask you a small favor. Please do subscribe, as this is the best reward for hours of work put into my videos. It's time to take off. We are already 14 minutes behind schedule, but we can make up for it in the air. The flight was quite uneventful but offered nice views out of the window. The crew first distributed the menus. Business class passengers received an email with two main course options in the days before their flight. I opted for veal terrine. Before serving the trays with food, we received a snack and a drink of our choice. I rarely drink wine, but you have to have some Portuguese wine while flying the national air carrier of Portugal. After I finished the snack and wine, food was ready. I particularly liked the shrimp starter. The main dish made me wish I chose the other option, which was panzerotti pasta. Other passengers told me later, they didn't like the taste of the pasta. For dessert, they could have offered something more original than milk rice, which for me personally and in my country is not a dessert but breakfast food. For this reason, I organized my own dessert and ordered port wine, which always delights me with its sweet taste. Even though we were flying all the way at the front of the plane, I didn't notice that the cabin was any quieter than the rest of the plane. The flight was almost over and we descended over Lisbon and flew over the 25th of April bridge. For exactly that reason, I knew that I had to get a seat on the right-hand side of the plane. In Lisbon, disappointing deboarding as we had to board buses. This is always an added complication and inconvenience that passengers do not want. This type of deboarding gives a good view of the aircraft, which is always handy for all flying enthusiasts. Here is the 20-year-old Airbus A320, registration CSTNL, which took me to Lisbon. Thank you and see you soon, TAP.